Today's the day. After months of controversy, the Sun News Network goes in front of the CRTC, and it does have some explaining to do. Last October on As It Happens, we told you about a Toronto police investigation based on complaints made by members of Canada's Roma community against Sun News broadcaster Ezra Levant. The complaints were in reaction to on-air comments made by Mr. Levant on September 5th of last year. Last month, Mr. Levant apologized, but that may not be enough. As today's CRTC hearings got started, a group of Roma and their supporters protested outside. One of those supporters is Bernie Farber, human rights activist and the former chief executive officer of the Canadian Jewish Congress. We reached Bernie Farber at his office in Toronto.
Mr. Farber, I think it's fair to say that you are a respected human rights activist. You're a prominent member of Canada's Jewish community. Why are you taking part in these protests against Sun TV because of what's said about Roma?
Well, this goes back, Carol, a long way. I am a child of Holocaust survivors, and I have a keen interest and a knowledge that during the dark days of World War II, there were two people specifically chosen for annihilation, to be completely wiped off the face of the earth, and that was Jews and Roma. And in fact, there are sayings in both the Jewish tradition and in the Roma tradition of Jews and Roma walking arm in arm to the gas chambers of Auschwitz. And so I feel almost a brotherliness, if you will, to the Roma community in that we have a shared common history. In many ways, what's happening today to the Roma is exactly what happened to my grandfather and cousins and others who attempted to come to Canada either during the course of the Holocaust and even before. They were not permitted to come here. And that kind of detestation and hatred, I think, is something that has to be dealt with straight on. And the Roma is a very unempowered community. And thankfully, over many years, the Jewish community has become empowered. I've thankfully received the ability to be able to work closely with many in government. And I just feel that kind of this brotherliness, if you will, to stand shoulder to shoulder with a very unempowered community.
I don't like to have to say these words again, but just so people get a taste of what it is Ezra Levant said. He says they're gypsies or shiftless group of hobos. They rob people blind. They mock the law. They'll steal your wallet if you try to help them. These are among the comments he made in 9-minute rant. What do you think the CRTC should do then about this application that Sun TV has made to be on must-carry service?
I think that we have to try and find a balance here. I know that there are those in the Roma community who would happily want to see Mr. Levant fired or the CRTC choose not to give, you know, a must-carry license to Sun News. I'm not going to go into the intricacies of the CRTC regulations. I'm just not familiar with them. But what I'm going to try and do is relate this to an experience that we dealt with in the Jewish community not all that long ago. And many of your listeners will recall that back in around 2007, there was a similar application made by Al Jazeera to get a license from the CRTC. And it was clear that at least one of its stations, Al Jazeera Arabic, had at that time produced a number of television programs that were vehemently anti-Semitic. And of that, there was no question. And so we had grave concerns as well if a license were to be granted to Al Jazeera. But we worked closely with Al Jazeera, and we came up with a compromise to establish a consultative committee that would see members of the Jewish community leadership meet regularly with Al Jazeera to discuss concerns and to learn from each other how best to go forward.
So you think that the best thing to do then would be establish some sort of advisory committee that would be able to keep some of the excesses of Ezra Levant or anyone else in check?
Ezra Levant apologized, albeit 6 months late. But in the Jewish tradition, an apology is only words. You have to put actions behind your apology. And I would urge Ezra Levant and Sun News to spend some time with the Roma community. Perhaps Ezra can actually go and, you know, spend a day at the Roma Community Center, meet with Canadian Roma leadership, get to understand that the Roma community has been here since the early parts of the 20th century, that they have been, you know, stalwart members of Canadian society, that there are not roving gangs of Roma traveling across Canada. It's absurd.
But you know that at the same time, that Ezra Levant has also made remarks that the First Nations communities find highly offensive. He's made remarks that certainly that Muslims find highly offensive. So where does this go? If you start with the Roma, he has to, like, what?
Well, you know, fortunately or unfortunately for Sun News, they have sort of hung their hook, if you will, on Ezra Levant as being one of their key entertainers. If that's what they're going to do, then they're going to have to be very clear. Nobody wants to stifle freedom of expression, but at the same time, there is an expectation of civility in this country. And I've argued passionately on many occasions in terms of positions that I have taken, but have always been careful and tried to always be careful not to make it personal, not to make it racist, of course. And if, in fact, Ezra Levant is incapable of maintaining a civil behavior, then Sun News is going to have to weigh that and decide how they're going to deal with that.
Do you think that if they fired Ezra Levant that you could support them getting this application?
I'm hesitant to say you have to fire somebody in order to get somewhere. And I believe that even Ezra Levant is capable of compromise. And he's certainly capable of understanding the kind of anger that has erupted here. And maybe through that understanding, there can be change.
How do you determine if there's been enough change that would satisfy you? What are you looking for?
The only thing that can determine that is the future. If he repeats the mistakes of the past, then the apology is worthless, and that clearly it was all meaningless and it had to do with potential criminal charges against Mr. Levant or this license application, and it was all a ploy. The future is the only indicator of how things are going to pan out.
We spoke just recently with Corey Tanaik, who is vice president of Sun TV News. He said that Ezra Levant has no hate in his heart, that he was only trying to be satiric, that he's not a racist. Is Ezra Levant misunderstood, do you think?
No, I think Ezra Levant is a very clever entertainer who has given Sun News a front page status. But I don't think he's misunderstood at all. I've known Ezra Levant for a long time, and I have also been very much the victim of his poison pen. And he has said some outrageous things about me. But, I don't know what's inside his heart, so I can't comment on that. I don't know if he's using race and ethnicity in such a negative way as a means by which to provoke. If he is, I think he's going to have to think this through a little bit more carefully. I don't know of any TV station, newspaper, or magazine that uses racism and hatred as a means by which to promote their agenda. Whether it's right-wing or left-wing, it doesn't really matter to me. Stick to policy, stop attacking, and quite possibly, Sun News could carry on.
All right, we'll leave it there. We'll see what the CRTC decides in this. Mr. Farber, thanks for speaking with us.
Thank you, Carol.